Vale, tío. Hoy aprenderemos el acento español.
Sugar Astronaut presents Spanish Made Easy.
Hello everyone, welcome to another lesson. Today we will talk about the Spanish accent that people have in Spain, or in Spanish, el acento español. Vale, tío. But before, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Before starting, I just want to say that I'm doing this respectfully. So if you're from Spain and you see that I make a few mistakes, please do not get mad at me. I have actually a video about this already, but I wanted to do it again because I have read many comments from you guys saying a few things that I missed, so that's why I'm making this video. Now let's get started. One of the main things about this accent is that the letter C and the letter Z, or in Spanish, C and Z, are pronounced in a peculiar way. In Spain, C is C and Z is Z. So what you need to do here, you need to put your tongue in between your teeth when you say this sound. So let's do it again. C, Z. This is very common to find in Spain. People pronounce those two letters that way. Now let's see a few examples. Cerveza, cerveza, cereza, cereza. So when you pronounce words that have C or Z, you have to not put too much emphasis on that. Once you start talking Spanish a little faster, the sound is more natural. Cereza, cerveza. For the letter C, you make this sound specifically when you have the vowels E and I, like in cerveza or circo. For the letter Z, you will have to pronounce it when using all the vowels. For example, ta, se, si, so, su. For example, zapato or zorro. Now we will talk about the letter S. I got many, many comments about this on my previous video. The letter S has a really peculiar sound in Spain. So people in Latin America usually pronounce S differently than in Spain. For example, the people from Mexico or Argentina pronounce the S like you pronounce the S in English. For example, salt. The S is really sharp and is like a S sound. Now the S in Spain is a little different, and I'm saying this because the difference is really subtle, so you won't notice it right away, but once you really pay attention, you can tell that the S is a little different. To me, this peculiar sound is a little soft, or softer than the sharp S from Latin America. I can totally see the difference between the letter S spoken in Mexico and the letter S spoken in Spain. So the position of the tongue is essential here. You place your tongue more at the top of your mouth rather than the bottom of your mouth. So the S pronunciation is more like like a subtle, really, really subtle SH sound that sounds more like S than H. So when you place your tongue the way I told you and you say S, the sound will be S, S. This is very, very subtle. So the pronunciation of the letter S with vowels is the following. Sa, se, si. So, su. Let's do it again. Sa, se, si, so, su. And now let's see the pronunciation of the letter S in, let's say, Mexico or any part in Latin America. Sa, se, si, so, su. Did you hear the difference? So the sound is very similar, but it has a tiny little difference. Let's see a few examples. Sabor, sabor, sal, sal, sí, sí. Now let's talk about the letters G and J, or in Spanish, G and J. These two letters are pronounced really strong in Spain, and the sound is like when you want to spit something out, like this. When using the letter J, you will use it with all the vowels. For example, ja, je, ji, jo, ju. And one word will be jamón, jamón. With the letter G, you will have to use it with the letter E and I. For example, gigante, gigante, or gente, gente. I need a lot of saliva for that. Lastly, another thing that Spaniards use a lot is the personal pronoun vosotros, vosotros. This is instead of using ustedes. Let's conjugate really quickly the verb comer, which means to eat in Spanish. Vosotros coméis una manzana. Vosotros comisteis una manzana. Vosotros comeréis una manzana. So these are just a few things to learn about this accent. Also, I will talk about the conjugation using the personal pronoun vosotros, so you can understand how you can use this personal pronoun and all the conjugation behind that as well. So here are a few of the YouTubers that I really like and that they're from Spain. So you can hear their accent and learn more about that. The first channel that I'd recommend is Necojita Blog or Necojita Blog.
No, nada, simplemente era eso, pues que uno le da vergüenza, ¿no? Al principio de pedir y no se puede poner ahí a pedir, venga, pues pide esto también, pide esto también.
And these guys are really interesting. It's actually a couple that are living in Japan. The wife is from Japan and the husband is from Spain. And I recommend you this channel. It's really, really interesting. So now the second one is Ex Caseros.
Pues aquí tenemos el increíble menú kawaii de hamburguesa. ¿Qué pasa, ex-manecos?
These guys are really fun. They experiment with different things, so you can check that out as well. The other one is Toniense. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly, but it's a really fun YouTube channel as well.
Tony, ¿cuántas voces puedes sacar?
Pues entre una y 100, a un número intermedio.
The next one is Ileo Vlogs. He makes really, really funny videos. You should check that out too.
Dios, qué feo salido. Vamos a repetir.
No, cariño, que yo soy guapa.
And lastly, I came across this channel actually today and it seems pretty interesting. And also it's kind of funny. And the name is El Canal de Cora. And this guy dubs videos, so he has like really funny videos of random stuff, and he actually do some voiceover. It's actually hilarious.
¿Se puede saber qué haces ahí?
¿Eh? ¿Qué hago de qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Qué semillas y qué semillas? ¿Qué insinúa? A ver, está ahora aquí tomando la fe.
So that's it. If you want to really learn this accent, I suggest you go to those channels. The best way to learn an accent is actually learning the accent from people who live in the country where the accent is from. Okay, that's all for today. Don't forget that lessons are uploaded every single week, usually two per week. So don't miss out and subscribe. Also, don't forget to click on the bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a new video. If you're fluent in Spanish, you might want to check out my other channels. One of my channels is just about food and interesting facts about it. And the other channel is all about applications, games, and all that fun stuff. I'm leaving the links to those channels in the video description. I'm on Facebook, Google+, Twitter, Instagram, Periscope, Snapchat. All the links are in the video description. Support this channel by sharing this video with your friends and by giving the thumbs up. Also by visiting my Patreon page. There are different perks when donating. Click on the Patreon logo on the screen for more information. You can donate as little as $1. If you can donate, please do so because that helps a lot to this channel. I'm leaving a link to the Patreon page as well in the video description. Thank you for watching and until next time.